Good evening and welcome to our Ascension Day service brought to you from the Parish of Bromsgrove with Dodford. Do hope you can join in all the singing and please join us in any text that is in gold, bold lettering. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Christ has ascended on high. He reigns forever. Hallelujah. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Hallelujah. We now sing our first hymn. Rejoice, the Lord is King. So we come to God as we are, trusting in his great love, in his mercy and his compassion. Seeing we have a great high priest who has passed into the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us draw near with a true heart, in full assurance of faith, and make our confession to our Heavenly Father. Together we pray. O King, enthroned on high, filling the earth with your glory, holy is your name, Lord God Almighty. In our sinfulness we cry to you, to take our guilt away, and to cleanse our lips to speak your word, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So may the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. The Collect for Ascension Day. Risen Christ, you have raised our human nature to the throne of heaven. Help us to seek and serve you, that we may join you at the Father's side, where you reign with the Spirit in glory, now and forever. Amen. Our reading recalls the narrative of Ascension Day, read by Sean.
Dear Theophilus, in the first volume of this book, I wrote on everything that Jesus began to do and teach until the day he said goodbye to the apostles, the ones he had chosen through the Holy Spirit, and was taken up to heaven. After his death, he presented himself alive to them in many different settings over a period of 40 days. In face-to-face meetings, he talked to them about things concerning the kingdom of God. As they met and ate meals together, he told them that they were on no account to leave Jerusalem, but must wait for what the Father had promised. The promise you heard from me. John baptized in water, you will be baptized in the Holy Spirit, and soon. When they were together for the last time, they asked, Master, are you going to restore the kingdom to Israel now? Is this the time? He told them, you don't get to know the time. Timing is the Father's business. What you'll get is the Holy Spirit. And when the Holy Spirit comes to you, you will be able to be my witness in Jerusalem, all over Judea and Samaria, even to the ends of the world. These were his last words. As they watched, he was taken up and disappeared in a cloud. They stood there staring into the empty sky. Suddenly two men appeared in white robes and they said, "You Galileans, why do you stand there looking up at an empty sky? This very Jesus who was taken up from among you to heaven will come as certainly and mysteriously as he left."
If you'd woken up this morning in Colombia, France, Sweden, Namibia, or a host of other countries, you'd today be enjoying a national holiday. Although in these times of COVID-19, it's unlikely you'd be able to engage in any of the normal pleasures of a day off, such as, well, relaxing with your family or having a meal out, visiting friends. In many countries, Ascension Day remains an important feast in the life of the church and an important cultural day of celebration too. But not here in Britain. Now, perhaps part of the reason for the decline in the Feast of the Ascension might lie in the festival's name. For the Ascension implies something about the location of heaven and God, somewhere up there, as opposed to down here with us. It's an idea that many today find rather faintly ludicrous, if not medieval. After all, we know a considerable amount about what is out there in space now, and heaven has yet to be found amongst the stars. Christian art down the centuries hasn't helped. You might want to look up Gareth Fallow's 1520 Ascension of Christ picture. It has Jesus rising to the heavens whilst giving a cheery wave to the folks below. It's not an image that lends itself to the modern mind. To some ears, the Ascension can even sound like a festival created for theological or liturgical neatness. After all, goes this argument, something had to happen to the risen Christ to round off his earthly life. The Ascension is not an easy festival to generate excitement about. The liturgy of Ascension Day affords no special section in common worship, but is wrapped instead into the distinct festival of Easter. And there are few traditions associated with the festival, although one is that on Ascension Day, the Paschal candle is extinguished to symbolise Jesus' withdrawal from the earth until we celebrate the coming of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, which of course is a week on Sunday. It's a bit tricky to bring much gravitas to that tradition at the moment. Let me briefly recap for you the story of Christ's ascension as we find it recorded in the opening verses of St. Luke's Acts of the Apostles. The event of the Ascension recalls the moment when Christ's mission on earth was finally completed and Christ departed to his Father. The risen Jesus has appeared to the disciples many times and has promised them that they will soon be blessed by the presence of the Holy Spirit. But that's not enough for the impatient disciples. You will recall how Jesus' years of ministry have been marked by the disciples regularly disagreeing amongst themselves and often failing to understand the nature and person of Jesus. Just before Christ ascends to the Father, the disciples again question Jesus about his true mission. And it is a conversation that reveals the depths of Christ's patience with his disciples, and reassuringly perhaps for us, it says something about God's patience with us. Even after the resurrection, the disciples' sense of personal responsibility is patently lacking as they ask Jesus, "Are you going to restore Israel now?" Jesus replies, "No, that's your responsibility. And you are going to do that, and not only in Jerusalem, but everywhere. And I promise you the Holy Spirit to come and guide and enable you." And it is at that moment that Jesus is lifted up and into a cloud and leaves their sight. The disciples are left gazing heavenwards, and it falls to a couple of angels with a degree of wry humour that reminds us of the earthly grittiness of Christ to declare, "Why are you Galileans standing here looking into the sky?" To which we might be tempted to add, "Rather than getting out there in the world and getting on with the job." The Ascension is a critical, pivotal movement in the development of our faith, and for two reasons. First, it is through the Ascension that Jesus ceases to be restricted in his reach by the physicality of the human condition. A single man relating to a small, defined group of followers in Palestine. And instead, he becomes available to all throughout the universe. A process that is affirmed and enabled through his presence in the Holy Spirit at Pentecost. And then secondly, at Ascension there is this simultaneous shift in responsibility for the mission of Christ, from the unique and individual personhood of Jesus to the general and universal people of God. The Feast of the Ascension marks the beginning of the process of Jesus becoming available to all of us, rather than to a few, and for all of us to share in the mission of God, rather than Jesus alone. The disciples were firmly reminded by angels that with the Ascension, Jesus was no longer to be found in his physical form, but elsewhere in creation, which begs the question, where? And how do we know when we have encountered the ascended Christ? One of my favourite pieces of modern religious music is a track called Resurrection by the group The Harbour Lights. It includes this beautiful line in the refrain. "Keep your heart wide open so you do not miss a thing." This is all we need to do to be aware of the presence of the ascended Christ. Keep your heart wide open so that you do not miss a thing. But awareness, of course, is not enough. The role of a Christian witness is not simply to be present to the presence of Christ, but to communicate the evidence of Christ's presence for the benefit of others. Right now, during these difficult and challenging times, this is happening more than ever, due to the outpouring of love amongst our community for one another. But we don't always acknowledge this and name it for what it is, signs of Christ in our midst. Many of you will be aware of the Ignatian Examine, a spiritual exercise, part of which is to acknowledge each day before drifting off to sleep those things that have brought you desolation during the day and those things that have brought you consolation. It's well worth the mental discipline to do this last thing at night, for a good night's sleep invariably follows. Another version of this might be to ask yourself each night, how has God been tangibly present, visibly present in my life today? And if I haven't already, when am I going to share that great news with someone else? The obligation to share our experience of God's presence in our lives lies at the core of our calling as disciples, building one another up to be confident witnesses to the faith, lies at the core of our calling as the fellowship of the church. In the lull that now exists between Ascension Day and Pentecost, we are given the perfect opportunity to reflect on this aspect of our common life. As we wait to celebrate once more the coming of the Holy Spirit, are there ways in which we could equip one another more effectively to be confident witnesses to the faith? Amen.
Jesus is Lord, creation voice proclaim it, for by his power each tree and flower was planned and made. Jesus is Lord, the universe declares it, sun, moon and stars in heaven cry Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord, praise him with hallelujahs, for Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord, yet from his throne eternal, in flesh he came to die in pain on Calvary's tree. Jesus is Lord, from him all life proceeding, yet gave his life for ransom, the setting us free. Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord, praise him with hallelujahs, for Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord, O sin, the mighty conqueror, from death he rose and all his foes shall own his name. Jesus is Lord, God sent his Holy Spirit to show by works of power that Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord, praise him with hallelujahs, for Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord, praise him with hallelujahs, for Jesus is Lord.
Having bought back our freedom with the giving of his life, Jesus enters into the full glory to which he is entitled. As we celebrate together, let us pray together. Each prayer ends with the words, both heaven and earth. Can you respond, are full of God's glory. Both heaven and earth are full of God's glory. God of love, as we celebrate this festival of Jesus' entry into heaven as Saviour and Lord, we pray for unity in the Church and reconciliation and renewed vision. Both heaven and earth are full of God's glory. As we recall the shouts of praise in heaven as the Lamb of God appears, we pray for all who are hailed as heroes and given great honour on earth, for all who worship anyone or anything other than the true God. Both heaven and earth are full of God's glory. We pray for all farewells and homecomings among our families and in our community, and for all who have lost touch with loved ones and long for reunion. Both heaven and earth are full of God's glory. Father, we pray for those who are full of tears and cannot imagine being happy again. We pray for the hardened and callous, whose inner hurts have never yet been healed. We pray for wholeness and comfort and new life. In a moment of quiet, we pray for those who need your love, presence and wholeness. Both heaven and earth are full of God's glory. We commend to your eternal love those we remember who have died, and we pray for those who miss their physical presence. Both heaven and earth are full of God's glory. We praise and bless you, God of our making, for the way you draw us deeper into the meaning of life. Merciful God, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
As our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Oh,
As we wait in silence, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. As we listen to your word, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. As we worship you in majesty, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. As we long for your refreshing, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. As we long for your renewing, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. As we long for your equipping, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. As we long for your empowering, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. And so may the Spirit who set the church on fire upon the day of Pentecost bring the world alive with the love of the risen Christ, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. So waiting expectantly for the promised Holy Spirit, go in the peace of Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah.